Welcome back, everybody. Courtside in the field house. Charlie Chitwood, Jason Burton, head coach of the Lion Women. And coach, another W. That's number 11 in the books. There's only one team that's ever done it before, and that was yours as well a couple of years ago. The one thing we didn't get that year was to finish.
Yeah, I'm praying we get to finish this year too. You know, everything's still crazy, and we've been fortunate so far to not be shut down, not have any games missed or canceled or postponed due to COVID. And you know, we're fortunate because we've been playing really well too, and to be able to get to 11-0. You know, there's only a few handful of teams in the country right now that are still undefeated at this time, and it's not easy, man, because you continue to get team's best shots. You have your own trials and tribulations that you go through. You know, we played another game today, shorthanded. But to find ways to win games, and you know, today didn't play any defense, but found ways to really score the ball. It's good to walk away with a win and be 11-0 going into Christmas.
Coach, we talk about double-digit scores, but we don't always have two of them that go in 20 points each and then still have three more that reach double-digit scoring. Like you said, though, second half, there's not a lot of defense in that one, was there?
I mean, statistically, there's a lot to brag on. You got two double-doubles with Desiree having 15 and 10, and then Yanni. I mean, that was an impressive performance, the way she distributed the ball today. 11 assists, 4 turnovers, but a career high in assists. And that's something that gets me excited, is that she's finding ways to create for others. We've talked about it. She could have more assists than that, too. We had a couple of times where we missed a layup or missed a shot that she really did a good job of facilitating today, moving the ball around. And then the way Shania scored today, it was vintage 1920 Shania. She really carved in that zone, found openings, shot the ball with confidence. It seems like her wrist is starting to feel a little bit better. And then she reaches 1,000 career points, man. And there's been a lot of great players to come through this place and play, but she's been a part of some huge wins for us throughout her career. And we needed her lift, her spark today to win this game.
And it looked like that last possession, when y'all were working out the shot clock, y'all were trying to work it into her hands for just one more to get it over the century mark.
I think, one, her teammates were invested this much. As you start inching towards a milestone, you kind of know that you're close, and then your teammates start pulling for you too, and the way they tried to find her and she took ownership of the game too, and she wanted it, and she didn't force shots, but she created her own shots. She shot the ball with confidence, and she played well on both ends of the floor, and you know, it would have been nice to get 100 for the third time this year. It's never happened three times in one year, but you know, the thing is, we're just finding ways to win the game, and couldn't be more proud of our girls for finding ways to continue to just win games.
Over on the other side, Marshalia Lally, she skinned you for 19 and 12 boards. You know you got to watch out for her. But how about you got to tip your cap to Ashani Eden, especially late in the game, the way she was able to knife through and lay up some bunnies.
Yeah, you know, if I was going to talk about one just really downfall, or actually I say two, was our rebounding. You know, we gave away too many offensive rebounds, and Marshalia, that's one person that is just a beast on the glass. And she was able to score a lot just because she got on the offensive glass. And she has a high motor. But, you know, defensively down the stretch, the way we guarded ball screens wasn't great. We let guards turn the corner too much. And that's something that we just got to clean up. You know, I give our girls a lot of credit because we just got through finals week. And so it is a mental grind on you when you're thinking about finals and end of the year papers and projects. We tried not to practice as much this week and took some more days off, and so you have to come in, you got to lock in the scouting reports, and we played three games in like 8 days, and so to do all that on top of having finals and to find ways to win, you know, there are going to be some things that may be a little deficient. This today was ball strain defense, but we found a way to win, and you know, they get a chance to go home and get some much needed relax and rest. So home cooking, all that. Just get away, get their minds off basketball for a little bit, and then when we come back, it's conference play. So, you know, hopefully we get in the gym a little bit, stay in some type of shape, and come back ready to play.
All right, Coach, ready to play. It'll be ready to play against Lone Star Conference opponents, games that matter. They all matter,
they
but
all
games
matter.
That count in the LSC standings, and it'll be Midwestern State, and they're going to probably still be feeling a little bit of a sting, and maybe they'll get a cough or something.
They hadn't played anybody. Like, we're their last game, and we're going to be their next game. And so, you know, that game is going to be they're still going to have that bad taste in their mouth from the last time that, that we played them. And we got to remember that when we take the floor, when we start preparing for them, when we come back, is they're going to be hungry. You know, how we guarded, it's not like how we guarded today, but how we guarded and what we did in the second half and in that fourth quarter especially, they're going to remember that. They're a team that has pride, and they're a good team, a good ball club, so they're going to be ready to play. So we got to make sure that, you know, after we get done enjoying our family and enjoying Christmas, that we come back ready to go, because this team is special right here. The team that we have been playing, have been put on the floor, there's a lot of youth out there, but this is a special group, talented, and have a chance to win a lot of games this year and make a deep run.
Coach, this is your seventh squad, and in my opinion, you are so strong up front compared to anything else you've had. You've had good post players, but you've got a bunch of them right now. And you look at Simone James, 4 rebounds. You had Juliana Lewis with 6, so there's 10 out of those two.
Yep.
And then add Layla Lawrence's 6, there's 16. And Desiree Colonel, she can come 10. In and get them. She gets you 10 more.
Yeah.
Do you feel like you've got the best post players in the country right now up front?
I feel like we have the best team in the country. I really do. I think we're deep at guard. You know, Jordan Beatty hasn't played a game in our post, in our front court. And hopefully we get a chance to get her back next semester. And then we played today without Mia Deck, who Mia Deck has been a really good player for us all year. And our guard play has been tremendous. This is the deepest team that allows us to withstand some injuries. It allows us to withstand some illness and things like that as things come up. Because, you know, to go to your point, to have Juliana play the way she played after sitting out last game because of an injury, and to come back and play fearless the way she did, huge charge to end the second half on their post player to draw on their third foul. And just make game-winning plays, rebounding the ball, finishing shots around the basket. And when that's just one of 4 posts or right. 5 posts that are really playing well for you, Dorian, who can kind of go back and forth between a guard and a forward.
Right.
It's a fun team to coach because we're so flexible, we're so versatile. But yeah, it's a lot of depth, and I keep telling our team, that is the strength of our team, is the depth that we have, the strength in numbers, and how they continue to play together through whatever, and however many minutes they're playing, they play together, they play hard. It's a fun group to coach.
Juliana Lewis returning after, it was 2 or 3 games that she was absent from?
Well, just one.
Just one
Midwestern.
But got out there, had the shoulder wrapped up. Didn't seem like she had the full range that she might normally have, but still seemed very comfortable and was even able to throw it, you know, two-hand overhead. And she came out well, huh?
To be banged up and to still put your body on the line, take charges, play in the post, play with contact, that's just who she is. I don't think she knows how to play any other way. And couldn't be more proud of her and just thankful for her to continue to put her body on the line, to continue to step up and show up for this team when we need her. And we needed to get stops down the stretch. So we needed her on the floor, and she did a great job for us.
Coach, congratulations. What a great ripping start to the beginning of this year. 11-0. And all the good stuff is coming up next.
It's a blessing, man. It's a blessing.
Love it. Love you. Have a great Christmas.
Merry Christmas
to you and yours.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
We'll celebrate New Year's Eve together, right?
Yes, we will.
In the daytime.
We will.
All right, folks, that's it. Women are big winners again, 99-86. They're 11-0, and there are only 9 teams in the country at the start of the day that were undefeated still. We'll see how long that can rock.
Yes, sir.
All right, go Lions. Men's games coming up next right here on the Lions Sports Network.